Are we allowed to be in here? Because usually five-star restaurants don't like the patrons entering through the alleyway.
Actually, the restaurant is closed for another hour. Please, have a seat. And a nice white burgundy for you while I work.
You work here?
I am still a cater waiter. I am still dirt poor, but I have been putting myself through chef school in Pasadena. I came on top of my class and won an internship here as apprentice sous chef. Lobster ravioli in a Meyer lemon and butter emulsion on a bed of sautéed baby watercress and fried capers.
You made this?
Kevin, in less than an hour, people will pour through those doors and this place will be a madhouse until midnight. And then the staff, totally wired and really beat, we have some wine. See, I wasn't drunk. It was the end of my first month here and I was really happy because I was changing my life. So, thank you.
It's changing our lives.
I'm so impressed at how you pulled your life together.
Does this mean I can't tease you anymore?
No, please never stop teasing me.
It is gonna take a lot of meals like this for you to pay your legal bill, sir.
That's fine by me.
You know what?
I'm sorry.
No, Scotty. I'm in a relationship.
Oh, so I guess I'm not the only one who's changed. Who?
He's the brother of my sister's fiance, and it's
the minister?
Yep.
Oh God! Wow. Where's this church?
Malaysia.
Excuse me, Artesia?
Malaysia, on an island called Tioman, which you might recognize from the movie South Pacific.
So he's really available.
You know, Tioman is famous for the red flying squirrels and the slow loris and the walking catfish.
Well, I'm really happy for you. All of you, including the catfish.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too. I should probably get back to work. It's about to get busy and I need some time to poach my full head in vermouth.
You know, it's just timing. Thank you.
Scotty. What? I'm so working right now. I can't talk. I'm sorry. I made assumptions.
Stop. Okay, listen. We were never friends. We just went straight to being lovers and fighters. And seeing as the only gay friends I have are my sisters, maybe we could try that.
Kevin, if I don't get this perfectly cooked piece of Copper River salmon to David Beckham at table three, you'll have to hire me as your personal chef.
He's here?
Yes. I'll call you later.
Now go.
Okay.
Saul. Scotty, Kevin's ex. We met last year at Nora's, the most awkward dinner party ever, the one with the fantastic mango peach salsa.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I remember.
Dinner party.
Thank you. Nice to see you, Scotty.
It was a big gay cocktail party. What more do you want from me?
Details? You're not honestly insinuating Saul was there.
No, I'm not insinuating. He was.
Okay, so it was all gay men and Uncle Saul.
Why do I feel like I'm being cross-examined? All I said was you never told me your uncle's gay. I was making small talk.
Small talk? This is small talk. Nice weather we're having. This is my Uncle Saul we're talking about. I think I would know if he were gay. You know what? A lot of straight people go to gay parties.
I'm just saying, if you'd seen the way he and this Milo guy were looking at each other.
Oh, wow. They looked at each other. How incriminating.
Why are you being so defensive?
He's dated women. He even dated my dad's mistress, for God's sake.
You said that relationship was doomed from the start. And how many 60-year-old men do you know who have never had a serious relationship with a woman? Kevin, it's time for you to take off your Prada shades and open your eyes. Kevin, why are you here?
Well, I called your cell phone, but it's disconnected, so I dropped by your place, and your landlady, who is really creepy, by the way, said you no longer live there.
Yeah, well, I would love to catch up, but I just spent the last hour deboning quail, and now I'm moving on to chicken, so now is not the best time.
Okay, fine, I get it. You're mad about the whole Saul thing, but, you know, disconnecting your phone and moving is a little extreme, even for you.
This may come as a shock to you, but what's happening with me has nothing to do with you.
Okay, fine. What does it have to do with?
I'd really rather not do this here.
I'd rather not stalk my friend for them to talk to me, but I'm here.
My tuition was due, so I fell behind on my rent and my car insurance and my phone bill. Turns out being a cooking student and apprentice sous chef isn't a road to financial freedom.
Why didn't you just call me?
Oh, what is it they say? Pride goes before the eviction?
Oh, come on, Scotty, this is me.
I know. You were finally starting to treat me like someone whose life wasn't a complete train wreck.
So where are you staying?
Oh, friends' futons, friends' sleeping bags, and last night, my ranchero.
You're homeless?
Oh, I like to think of it as being between homes.
Look, I've got an inflatable mattress. You should come stay with me.
Are you really sure there's room for me with all our baggage?
I have a boyfriend, and I'm in love, so...
And your missionary really won't mind?
If he's gonna be looking after poor school children, the least I can do is shelter a struggling culinary artist. Okay. Okay, yeah, I'll put the key into the mat. Good luck with the chicken.
Thank you.
Jason, I've tried every number you've given me, and I know I'm about to leave you the worst answering machine message in history, but I don't have a choice. There's no wedding because there's no baby. Kitty had a miscarriage, so I'm sure Robert would love to hear from you. I'd love to hear from you. Anyway, I hope you're okay. Bye.
I'm really sorry.
Yeah, me too.
Is there anything I can do?
Yeah, you could deflate the mattress when you leave. I tripped on it earlier. I almost killed myself.
I'm serious, Kevin. After everything you've done for me.
No, there's nothing. Thank you for the thought, though. Hey.
Hey. Did you hear from Jason yet?
No, but luckily I have enough work to distract me.
Okay, I cannot let you drown yourselves in legal briefs. It's too depressing.
Scotty, I am depressed.
That's because you miss him. But there are other ways to deal with it other than work.
Really? What do you propose?
Well, if you're feeling romantic about him, the Thornbirds. If you're angry at him, the Exorcist. And if you're just in the mood for a good time and my personal favorite, glitter.
Let's start with the Exorcist. Scotty? That doesn't look safe.
It lowers your blood pressure.
Yep. So does a glass of wine with far less risk of paralysis. Why aren't you working?
I'm on days. We could go back to writing notes if actual conversation is too weird. Oh, sorry. No messages.
Of course not. Do you want to be my date for Kitty's wedding?
Oh, how appealing. A spite invite?
No. Yes. A little. You know going to a wedding alone is torture.
What about Jason?
Reverend, God forbid I call you back, won't be there.
Yeah, but his brother Robert will. What will he think?
Who cares? Miatello's is catering. They're serving those little gorgonzola and potato pizzas with saffron and sage.
You had me a gorgonzola.
Thought so.
I come with decadence.
Wow, what happened? Did you rob the Long Beach Aquarium?
We had a shishi 6-year-old birthday party at the restaurant. Little Mermaid theme. Turns out the kids couldn't bear to eat Sebastian. The mermaid's best friend? Anyhow, their drama, our dinner.
Great. Would Sebastian like a little melted butter on the side?
I don't know, but I would.
Marvelous. Lights and candles, I'll be right back.
Oh, candles? I mean, it's just takeout when you think of it.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, sure. No candles. Well, we can still have champagne, right?
Sure.
Kevin.
Mm.
Kevin, go to bed. Actually, could you take your foot?
It's taking rain.
Sorry.
Mm.
I should go to my air mattress. Staring up at the stars, waiting for God to show me the way to your. Yeah, you should.